here. Now remember, anyone can learn how to draw, you just takes practice.
Sure.
Today's special art word is alignment. Now this is a word that will be useful in every drawing you ever do, so listen up and get ready to practice. First we'll draw some airplanes, one going in direction 1 and one going in direction 7. Later on, when we go over to the Secret City Mural, we'll add airplanes to the sky of the planet. Now the Secret City Mural is almost finished, so we'll take a special tour of it today, taking a look at the planet and the moonscape and the underground and the space station. Zebtron's here today, and he's going to make his own stationery so he can write to all his friends. Well, actually, I'm going to show you how you can create personalized stationery and notepads using your drawing skill. Now, I know you want to join the Secret City Club, so Zebtron will tell you how easy it is to become a member. Now, here's what you need to follow along. Are you ready? You need your drawing pad, your drawing pencil, make sure it's sharp, and your activity notebook to make notes on how to create your own stationery. Now, you get those materials together, and I'll be right back. So you all fueled up today? Okay, loosen your hands up. We're going to blast across that paper, and we're going to draw three-dimensional drawings right there, right on that blank piece. You ready? Okay, you have your pencil sharp. Now let's conquer this piece of paper with some three-dimensional airplanes, and we'll use that special word, alignment. You remember direction 1 and direction 7? Well, we'll use that with our airplanes to demonstrate how good control we have over this flat piece of paper. Draw your first guideline in direction 1. Now watch this, not horizontal, but slanting up just a bit. So direction 1 line. We'll make an airplane in the shape of it right here. There's our direction 1. Now, draw the body of the airplane. Curve the back. Very light guidelines, almost like a balloon floating up in the sky. And then along this guideline right here, go across and draw a direction 7 line. See direction 1 and direction 7? Now this is going to be our wing guideline to make sure the wings are lying down on the airplane. Draw the darkness here and then draw the back of the wing here. You keeping up with me? So you make sure these don't fall down like this, you see? They line up in direction 7, but not coming down. Curve the top, curve the back. Draw this peekaboo wing back here. This is the direction 1 line. So it goes across in direction 1. Now this is the problem a lot of people have on this wing. They draw this wing coming straight off the paper. Well, don't come straight up. Go across in this direction. Come back, direction 7. Draw the wing darker in the shape of the plane. And you can even draw a big bubble right here for the cockpit of the plane. And put a little pilot inside there, round circle. And then put the helmet on the pilot, curving down here. And then darken in the helmet. And then give the pilot a nose and then a body and make the inside of the cockpit nice and dark inside here. So it looks like the pilot's really taking off. It's a fat little plane. It's really cute, isn't it? It looks like the first airplane that broke this sound barrier. It's really tiny. Direction 1 line right here. Vertical line off the very tail end of the plane. Now we'll draw the stabilizer from the back of the cockpit to right here. Curve the line up. And let's draw the stabilizing wings right now. Draw a guideline in direction 1. Are you keeping up with me? These alignment lines are really important because you use them in any drawing. If you're drawing animals, or if you're drawing people, or houses, or birds, or anything you draw, you use the direction 1 and direction 7 guidelines, these alignment lines. So they're very important to use in practice. Even on your secret cities, you use them a lot too. See, I'm drawing two guidelines here, direction 7, direction 7. Okay, direction 1. And it looks like a foreshortened square right there, doesn't it? See, two dots far apart and your finger in the middle, foreshortened square, and then the peekaboo corner back there. Don't make that stand up too high. And then curve it back. We'll draw a contour line using that magic word contour. See how it wraps all the way around the volume of the plane. Leave a reflection at the top. And then put some shade underneath here, nice and dark. I'll even make it really black underneath the wing to make it look like you can really reach underneath that wing. Okay. You know what I want to do? I want to do something special to the back of the plane. Let's draw a place where all the smoke comes out of the back of the plane. Then we'll draw a flag tagging along behind the plane. So draw the string on the coming out of the... Oh, hi, Zebtron.
Commander Mark, I'm having difficulty...
What are you drawing here?
Deciding on details for my stationery.
This is going to be your state. Well, Zebtron, you know what? This is kind of boring. You know what, Zebtron?
Well, you know how to draw better. Now you've been practicing with me and drawing with me. You have to be sad. You can just take this as a foundation for your stationery and build upon it. Just draw some three-dimensional things, like maybe a simple table in one corner and maybe some flags and an interesting border. And maybe put your name instead of just writing your name like that. Do something different with your names. Use variety. Use some excitement in your drawing. I will go back and work on it, Commander.
Good job. I'll look forward to seeing it later, okay?
Thank you for your advice.
You're welcome, Zebtron. Nice and dark all on the bottom right here. Now, we're going to draw that flag on the back. I'll draw the end of the flag and then just draw one curvy loop right there. You can be having a little sign saying, "Eat it, Dwight's," or something like that right here. And then, in fact, I'll even write "Eat" right here. And then it wraps around. And then back here, you can see the vague print of the letters, like a little advertisement flying along in the sky. And then we'll put a shadow on the ground. He's flying pretty low. There you go. Now let's go on to the next drawing, and let's draw ourselves that space explorer going in the opposite direction. Draw the guideline right here, and then draw a really thin rocket shape. This is going to be our space explorer. At the very end, draw a large round circle for the space laboratory area. This is where the pilot sits and where they do all the experiments. And then draw a contour line, and then look at this. I'm going to put a foreshortened ring around the very front. Now shade underneath here, nice and dark, and gets lighter as it comes up. We'll put the cockpit space, get a new pencil, and then you can draw the little pilot sitting in here with his pilot hat on and little nose. And then here's another pilot. There's two pilots in there, a pilot and a co-pilot. And then maybe put a radar antenna on top here. Some shade underneath here. Okay, now back here at the very end, curve the end, and you have the shape for the sky lab or the space laboratory, the space explorer. I'm going to detail this in just a bit more. Let's draw the wings on the back. Draw a vertical line and then connect that. There's a stabilizing wing. Draw a vertical line coming out of the bottom and then connect the bottom. And then let's draw the back wing. You can just see a sliver of it because it's a straight-on view, so you just see that tiny little foreshortened circle almost coming along there. And then add some shading all the way along the bottom. Nice and dark, especially under the wings right here. All the way along here. Lighter and lighter as you move up toward the center. And use your finger to blend it across. And you could even write Space Explorer across the top here. And then shade this. And let's draw the Space Explorer doing a loop in the sky. You just zoomed up like this, and we'll draw a big cloud down here. An action line. See? Draw a little puff of cotton right here. Overlap it, and go all the way around. Make the cotton overlap around behind the jet propulsion stream right here. See, the stream goes right through the puff of moisture, the little puffy cloud. Right through there. Look at that action. Right there along the side. You can even put shading if you want to inside the jet propulsion. Along here. And then some shading inside the cloud. Maybe some stars. Maybe a little planet up here. You can do anything you want to make your drawing a little more exciting for you. This is our Space Explorer. Draw. Practice your drawing about 20 or 30 minutes a day. Stay in a positive attitude. And when you're drawing today, use direction 1 and 7. Use alignment.
Commander Mark has received so much letters and so many drawings from his fan mail and his club members that it is impossible for him to reply. But you should still keep on sending letters and drawings because he likes hearing from you. Are you a club member? If you're not, you should be. All you need to do is send your 3D drawing to the commander and you become a member of the Secret City Club. Here is my 3D name. I think I did a good job. What is this? It is Cindy's name in 3D. She stuck it to my outfit. She is a rascal, but not bad for a dragon. Here is club member Roland's 3D drawing. Nice job, Roland. Send your 3D name to Secret City Club, Post Office Box 444, Moraga, California, 94556, the United States of America, Planet Earth, the Universe.
You're drawing every day and you're practicing your drawing. You draw secret cities now and you draw pictures on a piece of paper really nice in 3D. Now I want to show you something else you can do with your drawings. All you need is your piece of paper, okay, and your pencil, and maybe a black pen. And I'll show you how to design your own stationery that you can write to your relatives on or your friends, or you can even give it away as gifts to your mom or your dad or your friends or even your grandma and your grandpa. Let me show you what I did here. Now, I designed some stationery. This is my little furball down here in the corner. This is underground inhabitant, the furball. And I said, a note from me along the top. And I drew some fancy borders along the side with some scroll, the paper curling up on the side. Then I took it to a local copy shop, and I had them copy it onto colored paper. Now, this is really cheap, but it doesn't cost very much at all, a few pennies per sheet. And I have the pink here, and I have a purple color, and I have green, and I have yellow. Neat design, huh? You can do all kinds of things with your own personalized stationery. Let me show you another design I did. I had took my piece of paper, and I really lightly took my yellow pencil, and I drew the design of Cindy's arm coming over the top of the paper and around the corner here. You can hear her mumbling almost, can't you? And then I put a note from, and I left it open because I know everybody knows what Cindy looks like, right? You know what Cindy looks like, don't you? The green arms coming over the side, hanging over the piece of paper, and growling and having fun and laughing. Well, I have Cindy hanging over here, and then I took the corner. See right here on the corner? See, I made a mistake, didn't I? I took my pencil, and I drew the line, and I took my pen, and I slipped, and it made a really messy area. So I took my white eraser. This is like typewriter cleanup. You take the white paint, almost like, it's called whiteout, and you take it, you dab your piece of paper, and you clean it up just a bit. And you can't even see that when you take it to the coffee shop. And over here, I did the scroll curling up with the paper in the background and then drew the border around the top. But you can make mistakes and cover them up really easily with that white paint and then take it to the coffee shop and the camera doesn't even see it inside the machine. And look at here, I made Cindy's in purple and yellow and pink. And then, of course, she's green, so I made a whole bunch of green stationery so Cindy can use it and write to her friends and her relatives. I did one more design. I did one for my mom. Okay, you could do one for your mom or for your grandma or for your grandpa or your dad. Look, I wrote a note from mom, and I put a cute little Hina Bear down here in the corner, and I have the paper curling up. And then I took it to the copy shop again and had different colors printed, copied up. There's the little paws. There's the dot right there and three dots around the foot to make it look like a real Unibear, of course, with the unicorn horn. Now take a look at this. My other design was the underground inhabitant with some stalactites hanging here. Oh, you know what? I did the underground inhabitant, but I put the moon bots in here. Kind of mixing up the secret city together, aren't I? I have a moon bot right here and a moon bot sitting up here, and they're talking. And what they're saying could be the note or the letter in between here. And I put another note from me, another moon bot saying that down to this fellow. So you can be writing inside your nice design and have your drawing spread out all over among all your friends and all your relatives, and they can all have the drawing in their desks all the time. Now look at this. If you want to make notepads out of your drawing, you take your drawing, take it to the copy shop, and reduce it and have it shrunk down. It's really neat. And look at what happens. It gets tinier. Now for notepads, you have to reduce it again so it fits in four to a piece of paper, and look how tiny it gets. And you just have that copied off into notepads, and you have little message notepads next to your phone. Do you want to design a piece of stationery together? All right, get your piece of paper out and your stationery, and we'll design one together. Get your pencil. We have a blank piece of paper here. Now, let's start with a border around the side of the paper.
Can I watch Commander?
Hi, Zebtron. How's your station design coming along?
I think I have worked on it satisfactorily.
Oh, that is really neat. This is neat. Look at this. You took the border, and you didn't just put a line around it like this, but you wrote your name real fancy down the side, and you drew a flag coming across, nice foreshore to me, and even a simple table. That's cute. Nice three-dimensional. And then you drew a line, and you don't want the boring corner here, so you made the side curling up.
That's really your neat. Suggestions, Commander.
Now you have your original. This is what you call your black and white original. Now you take it to a copy shop and get it copied off. Now, Zebtron, your lines are really nice and dark. You took it with the pencil, then you went through with a pen. But if you don't use a pen, your camera on the copy machine won't be able to see it. So you have to use a dark pen so it'll copy really nice and darkly. Let's take our pencil and draw a real light border here together. See, I'm leaving some space, maybe about an inch or so in. But on your piece of paper, it'd be about a quarter of an inch. And draw a light guideline. And now what are we going to do? Let's draw a flying saucer landing right down here in the corner. Take your pencil and draw a foreshortened circle down in the corner of your piece of paper. We're going to use that whole piece of paper. Draw another foreshortened circle right here. Draw the bottom and draw the top right here, the bubble of the flying saucer. Draw a leg here, curving, and a leg right here. And then landing pad. And then let's draw a landing pad right over here, almost like a foreshortened circle. And look at the back leg is a little bit smaller back here. Isn't this a fun idea, a neat idea, to make your own stationery?
Yes, it is, Commander.
You can copy it off and give it to all your friends, and all your friends can be walking around with little stationery kits that you designed. You can even design envelopes and bookmarkers and book covers for outside of books. Neat ideas what you can do with your drawings, huh?
Commander, I think I'm going to take this and get it copied.
Okay, see you later, Zebtron. I'm going to put a communication satellite right here. You know what I should have done? I should have had this turned around the other side like it was beaming up the message on the piece of paper. Oh, well, maybe I'll put another flying saucer over here and I'll do that. Draw a foreshortened circle again, and then draw a smaller one. Now, this is my pencil sketch. I'll go through with my pen later on and draw the nice dark pen lines, and I'll take my eraser and erase the pencil lines that I didn't follow. Draw the dome right here. In fact, I think I'll put my flying saucer dome popping open so the Martian can be coming out actually talking. And there's my Martian, and there's his body. And he's waving to everybody. Remember silhouette? Well, I'm going to use a silhouette here and just make the Martian really dark against this light flying saucer. All the way across. And now put that communication beaming the message right here. And then draw the dish of the flying saucer with your landing gear. These are the rough sketches. I'll go through with my pen later on and I'll add this shading. And then make the top of the paper curling around. That's a neat idea for the curl. You see what I mean? Make this curling. And then come in a little bit from the corner. Come down. It doesn't have to be straight. Don't use rulers. Make it nice and loose so they knew you drew it freehand as your gift. Makes it more special instead of using a ruler. Make it a really hard line right there. All the way along the side and shade it. Lighter as it goes across and darken that communication satellite there. That little dish. And then darken it in the back. The paper to make that white paper stand out. See, I go all the way to the corner right here. All the way down. And there's your piece of stationery. You take your pen now and you outline that, go to the copy store and copy it, and you have yourself stationery for all your friends and your grandma and grandpa and your mom and your dad and your uncles and your aunts and your dog and your cat. Let's take a look at the Secret City Gallery. Now we have lots of neat drawings. Look at some of these club members' drawings. We have a really nice self-portrait that little Robert did, and he put himself inside of a volcano. Isn't that cute? Put a whole bunch of little other friends and his family inside other little volcanoes with the hats on top. Isn't that cute? We have the hair, and he has a mouth, and he has the opening of the volcano. Good job. Good drawing. Even look up in the right-hand corner. He glued his picture onto his drawing so I could see what he looks like. What a handsome dude, huh? Okay, let's go on to the next drawing. And here's what Emily sent in. She sent in her drawing. She even has one of those little rainbow shirts on. Beautiful drawing. Let's add some really neat airplanes and maybe a space explorer to your Secret City. Are you ready? You have your pencil out so you can take some notes, and later on you can put this idea on your own Secret City. I will draw you see up here in the top corner above my little dragon or my dinosaur that's coming out of the pond, the Unibear Pond. I'll draw a direction one line, and then I'll begin the space explorer by drawing a thin line,
Then we'll draw the bubble at the end right here. This time we'll put a foreshortened square around it instead of the foreshortened circle. And then I'll put another bubble back in this back part. We'll end this rocket back here, or the Space Explorer. There we go. And now it's time for me to take my pen and draw a really dark outline of that pencil sketch we just did. Draw that. You know, I have an idea.
Why don't you teach your friend how, and better challenge than just teaching your friends how to draw, how about teaching your whole family how to draw? You could teach your mom and your dad. That'd be a challenge for you, wouldn't it?
And your grandma and your grandpa, and your aunts and your uncles, and your brothers and your sisters, and your other cousins, and your dog and your cat. Teach everybody in your whole family how to draw, and pretty soon everybody in the whole world will know how to draw.
Can you do that this week? Teach your parents and your friends how to draw?
Okay, you can teach them how to draw a Space Explorer, or a simple table, or a Unibear, or a Furball, or a Moonbot, or parts of the underground, or any part of your secret city that you're drawing yourself. You can teach other people how to draw. It's a fun skill to teach other people. All right, now I'll draw, let me see here, the back wing. I'll draw a vertical line. I use my pencil lines that I just sketched in as guidelines for my secret city. And then I'll draw the end of the secret city. Take a look at this for some really neat ideas to teach your family about. You get some ideas for your own secret city drawings or your own big giant mural that you're doing of your secret city or your planet or your moonscapes? I hope you did. I'm going to finish my Space Explorer by putting the tail fin on, the stabilizer fin, and then almost like a foreshortened circle or square right up here in that area so it stabilizes the flight course of the Space Explorer. And then I'll put my little person in there with an eye and nose and a smile and some hair. You like that? And then how about some shading? Underneath here, I'll use my other pen, my shading pen. All the way along here, then on the bottom, lighter as it moves up. And see, you can put foreshortened circles, foreshortened squares, you can put different segments on here, because anyone can learn how to draw. It's up to you, up to your imagination. All the way along here. You know, years ago, they didn't have flying ships like I'm drawing here. They had sailing ships. Now, here's what they look like.